Que safoda. Que safoda. Que safoda. Que safoda.
Hey guys, it's Michaela here and welcome back to my channel. But if you're new here, just welcome to my channel. Today what we're gonna have, or what I'm gonna be doing or showcasing to you guys, are my curly hair products. I'm gonna talk to you about my favorite curly hair products, some products that I sometimes use or not always use. I'm not really gonna talk about the ones I don't really like. Maybe not. We'll see how the flow of this video goes. If you're new here, don't forget to hit the subscribe button so you will see my videos on your subscription feed. And if you want to, please don't forget to hit the notification bell so you'll be notified when I post new videos. Okay, I feel like I'm getting out of breath and I don't know why. Okay, I'm gonna have to back you guys up just because I need to open my drawer that has all my products, my hair products. So let's back you guys up. Hopefully you don't lose focus. Let's open. Okay, so I'm gonna take a picture of what my hair jar looks like, my hair product jar looks like, so you guys can see. I'll have a picture on the screen. I have it in the Alex 9 drawers, or 6 drawers. It's pretty deep. Okay, so the first product I see is this Complete Conditioning Co-Wash by Cantu. Haven't used this yet, so I can't really tell you anything about it. What I can tell you is that I love Cantu products. You're gonna see a lot of them here. I'm gonna show you guys a lot of them here on my drawer just because I love them. They're very inexpensive. They're also, there's no sulfates, no silicones, no parabens, and there's no mineral oil. That's what it says right here anyway, so I don't really care for that, but letting you know in case you care for it. Something else that I do have is this Live Clean Apple Cider Clarifying Shampoo. I've used this a couple times. I'm almost done. I haven't really noticed any difference with this thing. It's supposed to be a clarifying shampoo. I think I use this about once a month. Or I've used this about once a month. Again, I don't really see any difference, so I don't think I'm going to buy this again. I'm just going to finish it up because I did buy it. I have here a Wave Whip Curling Mousse by Cantu. Again, I have not used this product at all, so there's nothing I can tell you about it. What else do I have here? I have this Olive Oil by Oars, incredibly rich oil moisturizing hair lotion. This right here is a holy grail. I remember when I was a child, my mom used to always use this on my head, including this pink product. I don't know the name, but if I find it online, I'm gonna post it up for you guys so you guys can see. I'm gonna put it on the screen so you guys can see, but this is really good for dry hair on your hair. The product is very thick and it's very creamy and it's also very oily. So you wanna be careful when you're putting it so you don't put too much of it, but this is a holy grail. You need this if you're a curly hair girl. But then, even if you don't have curly hair, you need this in your section. I have two OJX products. These two bad boys right here, the Biotin and Collagen Conditioner for thick and full hair, and I have here in the blue the Renewing Argan Oil of Morocco. These are both really good, and they both smell really good. I think they're about $7.99 each where I bought it. First, the smell, amazing. Second, it actually does moisturize your hair, or condition your hair, I think that's the word. Like, it leaves your hair really, really soft, both these products. And first I got this one just because of Jasmine, or Jasmine Brown. I thought I would try it, but I think this is the one she's on her videos. But then I saw this one, which said thick and full hair, which I do, so I thought I'd give this one a try as well, and there's no regrets whatsoever. I have this Cantu Come Back Curl Next Day Curl Revitalizer, I'm not even sure how to say. This is like a spray product that you put on your second day hair, third day hair. I've tried this a little bit. I wasn't sure if I was trying it wrong, but like, I think I tried it twice, and both those times I gave up because it just made my hair really frizzy. And maybe I was doing it wrong. Oh, I was doing it wrong. You see what happens? I didn't read the directions. It said spray on dry or not. It said spray on dry hair. Because I was spraying it on dry hair and was getting frizzy. So it says here, spray on dry or damp hair, section by section to restore, refresh, and revive curls, coils, or waves. This really didn't help me at all, so if it helps you, that's good, but for me, this is a no-no. Once it finishes, I'm probably not gonna buy it again unless I find a way to make it work for me. Cantu sulfate-free cleansing cream shampoo. This is actually my second bottle, so this I love. It's a shampoo that when you actually use it, I actually feel like my scalp is clean. It's like it's breathing. It's kind of like the what's that? There's that blue shampoo that my mom used to, like, the dandruff-free shampoo my mom used to love using that on me. She used to love using it on me because I used to have, like, a heavy case of dandruff on my head. Now it's not as bad as it was, or maybe it's gone, actually, because... No, it's not gone because I still have dandruffs. But, like, not as much as I used to have. And this, it feels like that one. Like, it just feels like my scalp is clean, it's breathing, it's, like, amazing. I have this Tresemme Expert Keratin Smooth. So this is like a heat protector spray. This is my second bottle. My first bottle, I had used it about halfway through, but then my cousin took the rest of the bottle, so I bought a new one. This I use to straighten my hair. I straighten my hair maybe like once a year, and this product has been working for me. There's also this other one my mom used to use, but I can't remember which one it was, so we're not gonna talk about it. But I will say that I barely use this. I use it once a year. But that one time I use it a year, it seems to work for me, so. I have a Dove Style Plus Care Amplifier Mousse. I have never used this. Never used this. I think I've had this one for more than 6 months, maybe a whole year that I've had this. I have not used it. Can't tell you anything about it. I have here Curls Lavish Curls Moisturizer, Second Curl Refresher, Daily Leave-In. This thing is just like the Comeback Curl Next Day Revitalizer by Cantu. I used it a little bit, completely pointless. I feel like these Next Day Revitalizers don't work on my hair, or it's just me because I don't know how to use it properly. So if any of you guys have any tips, please leave it in the comment section, because waste of my money. So I have two products actually that I got at the dollar store in Toronto or Canada. We have this thing called Dollarama. Everything is... When it started, it was $1, but now products go up to like $4. But the products I want to talk about is this L'Oreal Evercurl Sulfate Free Non-Drying Anti-Frizz System Wavy to Curly Hair. So this is like a gel or a cream. I think it's a cream actually. It's coming out as a cream. I used this maybe twice. What annoys me is that the cap doesn't close properly. That's one thing that pissed me off. Can't remember how I felt about this, but I do know that it was cheap. Probably won't be buying this again because I don't think I remember seeing any difference with this product. But the product that I did see a difference with, or that I did like, is this Garnier Fructis Style Modeling Jelly. I bought two of them. I think they're $2 each. Why? Just because I wanted to? I don't know, even know. Like, I bought them both at the exact same time. I had never tried this product, so I don't know why. But it wasn't a waste of my money because it does work. It's a gel. It does keep your hair stuck together, or your curls stuck together. It's really strong. One thing is I don't like the smell. It smells really alcohol-y. Yeah, the smell is not that great, but it's not that bad either. I told you, I have a lot of Cantu products just because it seems like it's the only product that works for me, or the only brand that works for me that is inexpensive. I lied. There's some brands of curly hair products that I haven't tried just because it's out of my budget. And I just can't, at this moment, I can't justify myself spending that much. If you can, that's great for you. Really happy for you. I have another gel here. It's the Cantu The Fun and Shine Custard. This is really good. It's my second bottle. My mom has the same bottle as well. It smells great. All Cantu products, actually, for me, they smell great. They smell amazing and they work for my hair. This is a holy grail as well, just because it's a product that I always use on my hair when I'm styling my curly hair. Like always. It's not super crunchy. People, if you put a good amount, your hair is gonna be good. It's not gonna be crunchy or overly crunchy. And if it is, you just squeeze your curls and it's gone. I have the coconut curling cream. I think I've used this once, or I haven't used it yet. No, I haven't even used this. Or have I? There's hair in there. I don't think, maybe. But I can say that it smells amazing. It smells like really, really good. There's hair in there though. I think I did use for a video, for my twisting video, but I can't say much of it because if I did use it, I just used it once, and right now I don't see any difference. A new product that I have that is gonna go in my holy grail. I used it once and I'm like, I used this on my twisting hair video. Not sure if the video I'm filming right now will be out before that video, but if the twisting video is out first, I'll put it in the description box so you guys can see it. This is how much I've used it. I've used it only once again. This is called the Cantu Moisturizing Twist and Lock Gel. So technically this is for you to use when you're twisting your hair or locking them. It says it's for you to touch up or just to twist your hair as well. So I twisted my hair and I kept my hair in a twist for 4 days. And I took it out. I took my hair out of the twist. And this is day 4 without the twist. And as you can see, my hair is still holding up pretty good. Like, technically this is day 8 without washing, without adding any product on it. And usually when I wash my hair, I always put this Shine Custard. But that time I used this as the last thing and the last product. And I'm telling you, this is going into my holy grail product because it held my twists really well. The smell was amazing and even the product was really good. I ended up adding a little bit too much of a product. I'm letting you just let you know, a little bit goes a long way. I feel like I overused this product. I abused it. Or the amount that I used, too much. My last Cantu product, actually, is it? Yeah, my last Cantu product is this leave-in conditioning repair cream. I used halfway through. This is my second bottle. It's a good repairing cream. It's a leave-in conditioner, but when I use it just because like it says it's a leave-in conditioner. But I use this as a mask, but it's not really that good. I mean, it doesn't say it's a mask, so that's probably why. But even as a leave-in conditioner, my hair, it doesn't really work as well as I would like it to. All I gotta say. The other products I'm about to tell you, I don't really use them, to be honest. One thing I will say that I did not, you don't have to buy, it's free, it's water. Water is an essential bottle. It's an essential product for curly hair. Like, water will revive your curls like that. It's really quick. And this, I just have it in a water bottle that I got at the beauty supply store. I think it was like $2.99. Really cheap. But yeah. So for my curly hair products, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you did, Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up, and see you in my next video. Bye.